I'm going to talk about poets, not about poetry. One of my oldest friends, poet ito, was the poet Rick Garrido Demetrio. How many of you have heard of Rick Demetrio? That's my generation. Wala. He was very, very good. But there was one critic who criticized him, si Pete DeRoy, sa UP professor din ito. And one morning, he opened the door, and there was Rick Demetrio. Wow! Sinampal niya si Pete. So, that gave me this one, because my wife said, huwag ka na masyadong maingay, wala na tayong kaibigan. So, what else? I'm going to talk about Jose Garcia Villa. I suppose all of you know that name, di ba?
Yes.
Oh, yes, okay. You know, Pepe Villa had a reputation of being nasty. He would insult his hosts. But actually, he was a very nice man. Pagkakilala ka, kapag gusto ka talaga, you know. The only thing I have about him is, because he was very good, by the time he got to be 50, hindi na siya buhay, patay na siya. As a poet, patay na siya. And this should be instructive to all of you who are writing or who want to be writers, you know, because nangyari yan, because I think wala siyang ugat. He celebrated only himself. Bandang huli, wala na siyang magawa, magawa sa may sulat. One lazy afternoon, the two poets, Fred Bunau, walang nakakakilala yung mga pangalan na yan, ano? Fred Bunau and Carlos Angeles. This was in the 50s kasi eh. Sabi nila sa akin, we were all working in the same building, the old Manila Times sa Florentino Torres. Sabi ni Carlos sa akin, oy Frank, itama muna yan. Labas tayo. There's a new burlesque house doon sa Raon daw in Quiapo. So, it was around 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and the burlesque house was open the whole day. Pupunta kami doon sa Raon. You know, in those days, many of the theaters walang air conditioning yan. Huh? And so, there was this girl on the stage, you know, acting out a burlesque sequence, and then she started stripping. And there was a very rude man sa front, you know, in the front, who was shouting, "Take it off! Take it off!" So, we were bothered by this man. So then the lights turned on. And you know who it was? It was Nick Joaquin. And turned it off. One of my most precious books, hindi ko sinulat yun, baka kala nyo sinulat ko, was written by, kasi may autograph eh. So, I keep it under lock and key in the house. Was written by Robert Frost. Do you know anyone here? Oh, good. Sunil Jose, kilala nyo rin. Anyway, I visited him in Vermont in 1955, and we went for a walk in the woods. He had a small cabin there, and it was summer, and daming mga summer flies, tapos kumakagat yan, masakit, ano? And I found out that he was then in his 80s. He was far healthier than I, you know. He walked faster than I. On my last night in Vermont, there was a, how would they call this, a dinner. This is the Breadloaf Writers Conference, Middlebury. And the star that evening was Robert Frost. So, very dramatic. All the lights were off. And he was there in the podium with one candle lamp. And then the old man, he was 80s, started reading his own poems. My God, what a letdown. He stuttered, he dropped the page, and he had to sit down, to bend down and flip it back. And after that, I was convinced that no poet should ever read his own poems. So, I now get to Arnell. You know, what I like about Arnell's poetry is that it is readable. It goes to you diretso sa puso mo o sa utak mo. I don't know if Arnell can read like Charles Lovecraft. These are ancient names which you young people don't know, but Charles Lawton is an English actor who read poetry very, very well. Now, like I said, Arnell's poetry is very readable, which is a virtue. As in many of the poets today, they are very obscure, and their poetry is very private, and you can't understand them at all. And I suppose this is one explanation for Arnell's popularity as a poet, and of course, you know, as a person. So Arnell, can you read your poems now? Come on. You don't want to be like Robert Frost. Okay, so that's all. And I want to thank you for listening to this old man.